Nick Rundinert here again. Today I'm going to go over a quick project that I did a few months back, but have finally gotten finished and finally getting around to editing the video. This is a voltmeter and a thermocouple and a clock which doesn't work at all, but it was a $10 part that I picked up as part of an order from something else, so I decided to include this, and I cut out parts in a pattern out of wood and just sort of made it as I went along, glued all the pieces together, covered them in the same black craft foam that I used in the console project, and then covered the exterior with the same black suede-like material that I used for the console also, as well as the race seat, which is another separate video that will be coming up soon. So this works pretty well. I've been pretty pleased with the results of the install. I wired it up with, there's a green and a red wire that are the signal wires. One is a reference voltage, one is a actual measured voltage, and the black is the wire to ground. So installs pretty nicely and gives me an idea when I ran the temperature probe, the thermocouple, through the firewall. I used a spot that you'll see a picture along the firewall inside and out that allowed me to run it through a grommet that already existed for I think it was the speedo cable or something else. Worked out pretty nice and came out pretty clean. Was able to install the thermocouple next to the cruise control and get the underhood temperatures, which gives me information that I didn't have otherwise.
What it looks like when you power it up. So let's go ahead and start it. So it'll give you clock function, your battery voltage, and temperature. So that's 14.5 volts, 12.15 is what it thinks, and 2 degrees C. Isn't that special? That's pretty cold for our Sonoran desert here. So I just started the car and it's idling with the air conditioner on, so this is just a few degrees above the ambient temperature. It's zip-tied right to one of the, I guess it's the throttle cable for the cruise control module. So it's just to the left of the intake. And no, that's not my hand shaking, that's just the car's natural vibration. So what I'm doing is kind of tracking what the engine bay temperature is in C so that I can get an idea of what the underhood temps really are. Even just sitting here after parking from the drive home, the underhood temps, shoot, they could be closer to 80 C. And I'll find out as things go along. I need to pay very careful attention to this kind of parameter so that I know exactly how best to manage the underhood heat for the turbo build, because that's the number one killer of engines. It has a clock which is highly inaccurate, so I'm not sure how they do that. But it also gives me a voltage reading for what the system voltage is at. So I'm really happy with this little tool, mainly because it has this added benefit of measuring the underhood temps, which, quite high. So if you're running a hot air intake, this is some kind of an idea just how hot the air in your intake actually is. If you've got an open element filter going straight into a turbo running 5 or 6 PSI, don't fool yourself. The whole, oh, you're only running 6 PSI, you don't need an intercooler, is bull crap.